Governor at one point said next year would be the year of education. I don't think so anymore.
Frustrated lawmakers reacting to the governor's call for deep cuts in the state budget, facing a sea of red ink. The spending cuts will have an effect on every resident in California on the chopping block. Road improvement programs, for also programs for the sick and the elderly, and even public education. KCRA 3's political reporter Kevin Riggs is live at the Capitol. Kevin.
Dave, as you might expect, a lot of glum faces here at the Capitol as we head into the holiday season. Tax revenues continue to drop statewide, and now the governor's office is said to be looking at a range of deep across-the-board spending cuts. The housing crash, the meltdown of the subprime loan industry, the Hollywood writer's strike, all are pouring buckets of red ink into California's budget, prompting fiscal comparisons to Southern California's firestorm.
There's no question that we're going to have a huge fire to put out here. It's looking more and more like a forest fire.
It's been just over 2 months since Governor Schwarzenegger signed the latest budget in state history. With revenues falling, agency heads are looking for a new way to cut spending, but the administration won't confirm a plan for a 10% cut across the board.
We are not going to discuss the internal budget deliberations, other than that there are a number of different scenarios that we have underway right now on how we would go about closing a budget gap that's above $6 billion.
So what might be cut? Republican leader Mike Valline says everything should be considered, and that includes K through 12 and community college funding, which is constitutionally protected by Prop 98.
But you're talking about possibly suspending Prop 98?
I'm saying that everything is on the table. I mean, I think there's been conversations between legislative leaders and the governor's office. Everybody said next year is a very difficult year. The next 2 years are. Everything has to be on the table.
Democrats say a bitter struggle lies ahead.
We're going to be getting dressed falling out of a tree again next year, and that's going to be a damn shame.
The blind and the disabled are the largest potential target, and seniors are the largest potential target. So, you know, Governor at one point has said next year would be the year of education. I don't think so anymore.
Now, you may recall the governor signed the budget here on August the 24th, 57 days late after a lengthy stalemate over spending cuts. Fears are growing here about similar gridlock next year. Dave, Lois, back to you.
Could get ugly. All right, Kevin. So here's a look at what is happening next. In December, the administration will update its revenue forecast and give the governor a range of options for balancing the budget. In January, the governor must present a budget plan to state lawmakers. In May, that plan will be revised based on the tax collection, and lawmakers are supposed to pass a final budget by the June 30th deadline. But as you know, that rarely happens.